John Hollinger, who writes for The Athletic, came out and said that I can very much confirm that the Pistons are intrigued by G League Ignite guard Jalen Green and could take him over Cunningham. I can certainly see this happening, but there's no way the Pistons would take him over Cade with the first pick. What they would do is they would require the Rockets to trade for the first pick, and then the Rockets would take Cade and they would take Green because they know the Rockets want Cade. So why would they take Green over Cade and give them Cade? They're going to take Cade and make the Rockets trade for him. So that's what will probably happen. But you have to understand that there's a reason why Jalen Green is drawing up so much hype. The Pistons, again, I'll say it, they're a horrible basketball team. I don't care. 70, 80, 100 dislikes on this video. Every single time I talk about Pistons, I don't care. Pistons, you're a horrible team. You're not going anywhere. So if you guys are going to go ahead and take Jalen Green, the dude has 1.2 million followers as a 19-year-old. He won't be 20 until February. So you bring in Jalen Green, you're now selling tickets. He's a box office superstar. He might be better than Cade as well. I think Jalen Green could definitely be better than Cade. I didn't think that until about like a week ago, maybe like 2 weeks ago. I mean, I thought he could definitely be better, but like realistically speaking, I mean, Cade Cunningham is 6'8 with a 7'1 wingspan. He's a better shooter, obviously a better passer. Does turn the ball over, but he didn't really have the best system for his ability. A system for him would be a lot of like high pick and rolls. I would say like push the pace, things like that. And he wasn't obviously in a college team that wouldn't have even been ranked if it wasn't for Cade. I mean, they're not gonna be able to do that. So if he does go to the Rockets with Kevin Porter Jr. and KJ and Christian Wood and these boys, I mean, it's gonna be a very good team. They're gonna push the pace. Steven Silas, his brilliance of how he coached Luka caused Luka to come out and vouch for him when the Rockets interviewed him. Luka said he was crucial to my development. And for Luka to say that, obviously for some other guys, he coached Steph Curry with his rookie season or whatever. I mean, Steven Silas, the big part of the reason why he got the job for the Rockets was because of praise from superstars. And Cade Cunningham's a superstar immediately. As soon as he enters the NBA, he's a superstar. Where Jalen Green has to earn it, I understand that Jalen Green has more experience, but Cade Cunningham is a generational talent. You don't find point guards that are 6'8 with a 7'1 wingspan that can create off the dribble, that can just shoot the lights out of it, that can get to the rim and get and ones, that has a post game. I mean, a point guard with a post game and a three ball at 40% is unheard of. You do not see those type of players. So why are the Pistons considering taking Jalen Green? Well, there's a couple of reasons. They're not good reasons, but one of the reasons is because of fit. Now, taking a player because of fit usually never works out. The Warriors took James Wiseman over LaMelo Ball. 1984, the Portland Trailblazers, they take Sam Bowie because they wanted a seven-footer. Michael Jordan was not drafted because he wasn't a seven-footer. So for the Pistons, they're like, well, we've got Killian Hayes, who's this raw prospect we took with a seven pick in the draft a couple of years ago, whatever. Well, how does Cade fit in with him? Because we want Killian running the point. So we bring in Jalen Green. Well, now he fits into the two. Killian's at the one, and we're set because we believe in Killian. Killian Hayes is a good player. But to take Jalen Green over Cade because of your belief in Killian Hayes is completely absurd, and to quite frank, it's actually ridiculous. It's repulsing. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. Like Killian Hayes, Isaiah Stewart, and Sadiq Bey, I'm big on. I picked them up in fantasy. Sadiq Bey won me $800, but come on, he's not a star in this league. He's not going to be an all-star in this league. He's not going to be a guy you can build around. He's just going to be a piece. He's not a role player. He's definitely a NBA caliber starter that can shoot the lights out of it as well. But like Pistons fans thinking that they have a brighter future than the Rockets, because to me, this is just about Rockets versus Pistons. Like you guys, like Pistons fans just come on the channel and they're like, ha, we won the lottery over you guys. Bro, your roster is horrible. Dude, watch next season. No matter who you get, Green or Cade, you're at the bottom of the East. Like imagine being at the bottom of the East after getting the number one pick, bro. It's actually embarrassing. I mean, the last time the Pistons went to a conference finals was what, 2008? I mean, they did win a ring when they had a, was it? I barely know anything about the Pistons. I think it was 2003. I think because remember they took Darko Milicic over Carmelo and then they won the championship without Darko, or I guess with Darko, but he sucked. And then they did go on to, I don't know. You guys know, I don't know shit about the Pistons. I can't act like I do, but I know they went to a ton of conference finals like during that stretch of era. And then after that, they haven't done anything like again. So when was the last time they even made the ball with Blake Griffin? And then they got swept by the Bucks, or did they win? They got swept, right? I mean, Blake Griffin. This is proof how bad the Pistons are, because Blake Griffin pretended to not be able to play basketball, gets bought out, and then goes to the Nets and turns it back. I mean, Blake Griffin was incredible for the Brooklyn Nets. He wasn't dunking over, I mean, he did dunk on Giannis, but overall, he wasn't the Blake Griffin he was even in that first year with Detroit. But, man, he had a couple of double-double games, like 18-14. I mean, he was the only one that really could defend Giannis, and that's kind of crazy because Giannis is a two-time MVP. I mean, could have been three this season as well. But, I mean, you guys kind of get the gist. Like, the Rockets, they do have a chance at Cade. It's a pretty good chance. Like, it's, I don't know if it's 50-50. I'd say it's probably like 60-40. I mean, the Pistons are definitely going to take Cade, but they might end up trading for Green and more assets. So let me read you guys the actual report, because you have to pay to read it. It's from The Athletic, so it's like $4 a month. It's really cheap, and I would recommend it. I used to have The Athletic, but that was like, I don't know. I used to have it, but I never really read anything, so I canceled it. But it's pretty good. So this is what Hollinger says. So Detroit obviously was the big winner of Tuesday's draft lottery after landing the top overall pick. The number one player on virtually every public draft board is Oklahoma State wing Cade Cunningham, but it's not a slam dunk that Detroit takes him. This has been reported other places already, including by our own Sam Vecini, but I can very much confirm that the Pistons are intrigued by G League Ignite guard Jalen Green and could take him over Cunningham. Regardless, the Pistons will pick somebody. The chances of Detroit trading down seem minimal, and my spies were equally skeptical of Houston at number 2 and Cleveland at number 3 looking to move back in return for multiple picks. Okay, so he doesn't see the Rockets or Cavs trading back, which would mean they would fall outside of the Jalen Green, Cade range, and even Evan Mobley for multiple picks. I mean, I don't know why they would. Like, these are two bad teams. The Cavs are not a good team. Even at full strength, the Cavs just are not a good team. And they're paying Kevin Love a lot of money. They're going to be pairing Jared Allen. They're paying Colin Sexton a lot of money. And all three of those guys, as good as they are, they're not going to really be able to win a lot of basketball games, especially Colin Sexton. He's got to work on his playmaking and leadership as well. So in the Houston Rockets, like, they have no reason to trade down for multiple picks. The Rockets need a superstar. Their best player is Christian Wood. I love me some Christian Wood, but he's a 20-10 guy. Like, again, 20-10 sounds amazing, but Kelly Olynyk averaged 19-8 for the Rockets as a starter. So is 20-10 that? I mean, yeah, it's very good, but it's not like 25-12, right? It's not 28 a game, 31 a game like Bradley Beal. I mean, Jalen Green is number one scoring potential. So the bottom line is the Houston Rockets are the biggest winners of this video because they might get Cade Cunningham without even having the first pick. Or they're going to get Jalen Green. So at the end of the day, who's really the loser here, bro? It's the Detroit Pistons, because the Rockets, they have KPJ, they've got Tate, they've got Wood, they've got the second most draft capital until 2028. They've got a ton of studs around them. They've got Steven Silas, who multiple superstars came out and vouched for him, including Russ and Harden, even though they left. It was nothing to do with Silas. It was a variety of reasons. I mean, Steph Curry, Luka Doncic. I mean, overall, bro, the Houston Rockets have the brightest future in the NBA because they've got all these picks. They're going to have Jalen Green, Kevin Porter Jr., Christian Wood, Tate, KJ, Armani Brooks, the sniper himself. And they have the 23rd pick, the 24th pick. Next year, they actually own Detroit's pick, future Milwaukee pick. Like, overall, Wizards, bro, it's just the Houston Rockets, like, if you're a fan of them, next season it might not be as intriguing as you would like because they have their pick and they might just go all in on the tank. I hate to say this, but next season they might trade Christian Wood for assets and just tank and try to get another pick. But then after that, it's going to be time to go because now you've got Jalen Green, KPJ. You've got that top pick in the draft. You've got obviously the guys that I've mentioned like 5 times in this video. I'm just pretty happy about the Rockets' future, guys. Hope it's a good one, bro. I really do, man. I have a good feeling about it, but I mean, we can't predict the future. So we just got to hope that this works out, that Stone makes the right decisions, that Silas does what he needs to do. And yeah, because these coaches are sticking around, man. Like, coaches, there's new coaches like every single season, it seems like. So hope it works out for Silas. I'm sweating. It's very hot outside. Hey, Suri, what's the temperature right now?
It's about 91 degrees outside.
I am sweating my balls off, boys. But again, bro, to Detroit Pistons fans, if you're still watching, like, bro, there's some mad chill Pistons fans. But like, to come into my videos and even I didn't even say anything about it. But actually, yeah, I did. I guess I deserve this. Like, who am I kidding? Guys, enjoy the rest.